The time when Kerbalkind had conquered space, following a bloody years-long war on Kerbin, the Kerbal United Nations was formed. They sought to bring lasting peace to the solar system, and for a season, they did. Laythe, the innermost moon of the gas giant Jool, a place where both Kerbals and the roaring jet engines of their aircraft can breathe. It wasn't long after the Great War when it was discovered that Laythe had oil. The Kerbal United Nations feared this would cause another conflict, so they split the moon up between the nations of Kerbin. All of these countries could freely do whatever they wished, with one strict condition. No nation was to create a military presence on Laythe. And if they did, swift action would be taken against them. Over the decades, Laythe would see its fair share of scandals, but none like what happened when Kerbal UN officials seized a supposedly normal shipment of mining equipment from the manufacturing nation simply known as the Independent Design Bureau. They found it to contain much, much more than just mining equipment. It was heading for the North Pole of Laythe, the territory of the Kerbal Socialist Republic, or KSR. They found after close reconnaissance that under the cloud cover of Laythe's North Pole, the KSR had not only been building a military, but they had built a truly massive military. An emergency council of the Kerbal United Nations was called. The treaty had been broken, but was it worth another war? What happened next would be called by some members of the council an overreach, an unlawful invasion to seize land from the KSR. Either way, it was too late. The KUN activated its Laythe Defense Force and launched three F-4E Phantom IIs provided by the United States of Kerbin toward a KSR base on Laythe. The first of many battles in the Laythe Wars. I'm Smoothie Chat, and this may seem like a bit of a random video if you were expecting a colony series video next, like I said I was going to do, but this whole concept was so cool I had to get this out as quick as possible. So basically, this is going to be a new series on the channel where you guys can participate in an ongoing war on Kerbin and on Laythe, and I'm going to be ruling the two main factions, the USK and the KSR, but everything else is going to be completely generated by you guys. The crafts that you're seeing here on the screen are from the great guys and gals on Discord that helped me come up with this idea. It wouldn't have gotten this far at all if it wasn't for them, so big thanks to them and everything. But All you have to do to participate is click the Discord link. I'll put that in the pinned comment and in the description. And either ask to join an existing nation if you like any of the ones that are existing, or if you want to make your own one while supplies last. I mean, we're running out of room on Kerbin really, really quickly. So we might have to start deporting some countries to Laythe. But while supplies last, you can make your own nation. Just provide me with a flag and name of your nation and pick out the land if there's any left. And you can participate in it. You'll also need to provide some sort of craft files, like fighters and stuff. This is mostly going to be aerial combat, though there's going to be a lot of ground stuff, a lot of navy stuff, probably a lot of navy stuff the farther that it goes on. I mean, Laythe is mostly ocean after all. But yeah, you can participate, and then once you're a nation or you're part of a nation, you can help make decisions. You'll get access to the Kerbal UN channel in the Discord, where you can discuss and make decisions with the rest of your colleagues in the Kerbal UN. And basically all of these videos are going to be like almost news updates on what's going on in the war, and it's going to be every little conflict that you guys come up with. And I'm going to try to cover absolutely everything that I can, within reason, within reason. I have a really crappy computer and a really short attention span, so yeah. So make sure to subscribe if you aren't already, so you don't miss the next and first official episode of this. And for you Colony Series fans out there, I will be fixing up my Minmus base next. That's going to be the next Colony video, and it is going to be next this time, I swear.